Hello everyone, Jirago1 here, and today we're going to be installing Windows 2000 on an SD card. Now you may be thinking, you're an idiot. Well, you'd be right. Running an OS off an SD card is tremendously slow, especially when you have one like this, which is only 30 megabytes per second read, and even less write. But we're going to do it anyway, just for the sake of I don't know. Now, we're not going to be using a USB adapter, and this laptop doesn't even have an SD card reader. Instead, we're going to be using this. This is a pretty generic $10 PETA or Mini IDE adapter that we'll be installing into this Gateway 200 ARC. And this is what it looks like in the adapter. Installation is pretty simple. So you may be wondering, who in the world is going to want to use this? Well, not too many people, because it's going to be very, very slow. But for me and this laptop, we go way back. And I don't want to see losing a hard drive take it out. And besides, it'd be nice to have a quote-unquote solid-state laptop to carry around with me. And once we got this in, we'll be ready to go. And if we're lucky, the 200 ARC should recognize the SD card as a 30 gig hard disk. So, as you can see here, our SD card adapter is shown in the BIOS by name. And it does show up as 30 gigs. Alright, let's start rolling. Okay, so we're back. I've already pre-formatted the SD card because the Windows 2000 setup here does not like formatting SD cards. So let's keep the current file system intact and hope that it can copy files to it. Whew! Alright, we're rolling. Now, I've tried to install Windows on an SD card before, and this initial file copy takes a lot longer than what I'm used to when I install on regular mechanical hard disks, but this is actually going at a pretty okay rate, so I think we might be okay here. Alright. Looks like moment of truth here. I'm going to eject the installation CD so that it doesn't boot to it automatically. And this is the ultimate moment of truth. Can it boot to the SD card? Not too shabby. Looks like it's starting Windows. And if it's gonna blue screen, it's gonna be right here. Disk's back in the drive. Hey, we got in, we're in! Now this Gateway 200 ARC is a 2002 computer, so it's should be well acquainted with Windows 2000. Yes, this is taking an incredible amount of time. I'm not sure how long it's gonna take for this to install, but I hope that the boot times for this is gonna be at least somewhat reasonable. I would like to use this machine as just a very basic web computer, although it's not going to be very ideal if I'm going to be using Windows 2000. I haven't run into any errors yet, so looks pretty good. Alright, final stretch. This is actually going pretty good now. This is, in fact, the end. I haven't installed Windows 2000 in a while. I don't remember what the final screen of installation looks like. This is probably it. So if you've been wondering throughout this installation why I decided to install Windows 2000, well, Windows 2000 is a little bit more lightweight than Windows XP. I originally wanted to install XP, but this is a little bit lighter in terms of installation size, and it'll definitely boot up faster on this system. I just think it's gonna be really satisfying to have a solid-state laptop, with the exception of the optical drive.
Hello, cutie pie.
Alright, this is it. Initial boot is probably going to be a little bit longer than a normal boot, but it's going to be pretty close. Oh, crap. And here we are, the Windows 2000 desktop, with a not too bad boot up time. We weren't sitting here for 5 minutes. Here we are. Delicious, delicious. It works. Of course. So a few hours ago, right after I tried to restart the machine, it stopped detecting the adapter again. So after I stopped recording to go look for the drivers, it stopped detecting my SD card adapter in the BIOS. So I shut it off for a while and left it alone, unplugged. And when I brought it back up again to see what was going on, it booted perfectly fine. It was actually quite fast. And so if it actually manages to do the same thing again, we'll see how long it takes. That's pretty snappy. I think that's actually faster than my SSD. Holy crap. Although this doesn't have anything installed on it and it has no drivers, it's just the SD card, 34 second boot up, Windows 2000. It's got a 1.4 GHz processor, Pentium M from 2002 or something. That's not bad. That's pretty good. Wow. Yeah, so it's kind of nice. However, I haven't put it under any stress. That's just reading. That's not writing. That's just reading, and it's pretty fast at reading. So if it comes down to actually doing heavy write operations, we might be out of luck. Alright, so we're back. Day two of this little project. I managed to get all the drivers installed. It took a little bit more time than I thought it was going to take, because I had to manually search for each one of the device drivers, and the original gateway drivers from their website are now gone. I can't find them anymore, so what I did is I used a little program called Everest, which allows you to see what devices are on your system, and you can just specifically go to Intel most of the time to get the device driver for the Extreme Graphics, in this case, the Realtek audio. As you can see, the audio is working here. So it works. The drivers work. I didn't install all the drivers because I didn't really need other stuff. I like the PCMCIA slot. I'm not going to use that. So the Ethernet drivers install. The wireless drivers installed. Still have to use Intel ProSet in order to find networks, and not too happy about that, but it works. As you can see, we're watching YouTube video. Now, to run the latest version of Firefox on Windows 2000 took a little bit of a workaround. You have to install third-party unofficial Windows 2000 service packs, update Rollups, and then you have to make a DLL modification to Firefox itself. You have to put a custom DLL file in the Firefox directory. You have to run a special program to allow the Firefox installer to run, because it will not run on any system lower than XP Service Pack 2. So this is the latest version of Firefox. This is Firefox 28. I don't know if you can see that. It's HD, but it's probably still pretty small. And then to install Flash, I could only use Flash Player 11, and I had to do a hack. I had to actually hack the executable with a hexadecimal editor, change a value so that it would install on Windows 2000, and as you can see, it works perfectly fine. It'll give you a warning saying that it's a vulnerable version of Flash Player and you should update it, but hell no, I'm not going to do that, because trying to get it to work a newer version is just a pipe dream. So I'm just glad it works as well as it does right now. All the drivers working and running off of an SD card as its main boot volume. I'm very, very pleased. This turned out way better than I expected. And if you want to try it, any of this yourself, if you have a Gateway 200 Arc or maybe just an older laptop that has a mini IDE slash PETA, whatever you want to call it, I have all the links for everything I did in the description, including my own little driver package for the Gateway 200 Arc, this laptop right here, because there isn't one really anywhere. You can of course use Everest, which I'll put a link for in the description as well, to check out the hardware on your laptop, figure out what sort of drivers it needs. You might be surprised that there will be drivers for Windows 98 for this sort of stuff, so the possibilities are, well, as limited as Intel's website is for the most part. So yeah, that's it, we're done. This is gonna be pretty fun to use, I think. There's still a lot of people out there that are trying to keep Windows 2000 alive, and it's really, really cool. So just check out the links in the description, and I'll see you next time.